Welcome. In this video, we will discuss about the Data Governance Quality Index, which is released by Niti Aayog. So, this is another index which is designed by Niti Aayog to check for the various ministry and how they are performing in terms of the various schemes under them. So, this is basically the Data Governance Quality Index. Apart from that, Niti Aayog also releases other index. A major one is Composite Water Index. State of Health Report. So basically it goes with the state-wise status of health, how much every state has performed in terms of health sector. Then Quality of Education, School Quality Index. Also, Niti Aayog releases the Innovation Index. So, India Innovation Index is released by Niti Aayog. So, this is just for your information. So, whenever you are trying to read about any topic, try to make it more holistic. Try to encompass everything which you have known about it. It will definitely help you to connect the dots and you will be able to realize it in a better way. So this is the basic background. Let's move forward. In this particular video, we will focus on Data Governance Quality Index. So let's begin. Data Governance Quality Index survey was conducted by Development Monitoring and Evaluation Office, which is DMEO, under Niti Aayog, to assess different ministries department performance on the implementation of central sector schemes and centrally sponsored scheme. Later in this video, we will also discuss what is the difference between central sector scheme and centrally sponsored scheme. But right now, just remember that this particular index will try to check all the list of the schemes which are under any ministry or department and see how well they are faring in all the departments. So its objective is to drive healthy competition among them and promote cooperative peer learning from best practices. So basically the idea behind coming up with this index is that so that some of the ministry would be coming as a role model and such best practices could be adopted by other ministries also, and it will lead to healthy competition among the ministries. Six major themes of DGQI, which is your Data Governance Quality Index. It is data generation, data quality, use of technology, data analysis, use and dissemination, data security, HR capacity, and finally your case study. So these are the major themes on which DGQI works. Now, how they have segregated the ministries or how they have classified the ministry and departments, so they have again classified them in six categories. What are these categories? These are your administrative, strategic, infrastructure, social, economic, and scientific. So these are the basic category along which the ministries are classified. Administrative, strategic, infrastructure, social, economic, and scientific. And finally, just a GK fact, that Department of Fertilizer, which is under the Ministry of Chemicals and Fertilizer, has been ranked third out of the 65 ministry and department with a score of 4.11 on the scale of 5 on Data Governance Quality Index. So this is just an what you can say and GK fact that you could remember. But the things that you have to remember is, first of all, it is conducted by Development Monitoring and Evaluation Office. Then it is what is the major objective? To drive the healthy competition among ministry. Just remember these things. Now let's move forward and try to understand what central sector schemes are. So what are the central sector schemes? The major thing you need to know is they are 100% funded by the central government. So all the fund which is required for any scheme to go through, that will come directly from the central government. So this is one of the major thing about central sector scheme. These are also implemented by central government machinery. So unlike the central sponsored scheme, central sector schemes are also implemented by the central government machinery. They are mainly formulated on the subjects of union list. So just for your FYI, schedule 7 of our Indian constitution consists of union list, in which only the central government or only the parliament has the power to make laws, state law, state list, in which the state legislative assemblies could make law, and finally concurrent list, in which both of the state legislative assemblies as well as their union parliament could also make law. So these are the three basic lists which are present in the Schedule 7. And for your information, central sector schemes are generally based on the subjects which are mentioned under the union list, because the central government is the sole executor over here, as well as funding is also provided by the central government. What are the few examples of central sector schemes? So you have BharatNet, which is like the optical fiber connection provided to the panchayats. Then you have Namami Gange National Ganga Plan. So such kind of schemes are central sector scheme. So I hope you have understood this part. Now let's move forward and try to understand what are centrally sponsored schemes. So let's understand that centrally sponsored schemes are the scheme by the center where there is financial participation by both center and state. So basically what happened over here, generally for most of the state, the funding pattern is 60:40, which means that the 60% would be borne by the center and 40% would be provided by the state. For some hilly states and northeastern state, the ratio is 90:10. Which means the 90% would be provided by the center and 10% by the state. This is for hilly state and northeast. Hilly plus northeast state. So this is the major distribution of fund with regard to centrally sponsored scheme. Here states also participate. Centrally sponsored schemes are again divided like core of the core scheme and finally optional scheme. So for your benefit or for you to learn, you cannot, so there are a lot of scheme and core scheme and optional scheme. So the main idea is at least you know the core of the core scheme so that you can at least segregate. So in your like objective question, they could ask that whether this is the core of a core scheme or not, whether it is a core of a core centrally sponsored scheme. Such kind of statement could come. So for your easy accessibility, it's better that you remember at least the six core of the core centrally sponsored scheme. Which are these? This is National Social Assistance Program, MG Narega. Then you have Umbrella Scheme for Development of Scheduled Caste, Umbrella Scheme for Development of Scheduled Tribe, Umbrella Scheme for Development of Minorities, and Umbrella Schemes for Development of Other Vulnerable Groups. So basically these are the vulnerable groups on for which these schemes are planned. And then you have MG Narega and National Social Assistance Program. So these are the core of the core centrally sponsored scheme. So I hope you have understood this video. If you have any doubt, feel free to drop a comment. Thank you.